Large social gatherings have been blamed for the rise in COVID cases. According to health officials, many of these have been noted especially in the communities where the most cases of COVID-19 have been recorded. The Ministry of Health has been managing a few cases identified in the nation's schools, but that is under control, according to the chief medical officer.
We continue to ask the public that health and safety needs to be the priority. One of the issues which we note, for example, with the school reopening, and this is one of the things we need to address. If someone is in quarantine or isolation or suspect case, the kids of that person should not be sent to school. This is one of the issues that we're noting in the few cases we've had to manage. So parents need to know when to keep your kids home. If you are on quarantine or isolation, we ask that you stay in. You should not be out. Exposing yourself to other persons. We continue to ask persons to wear your mask, avoid large crowded areas. We still have too many active cases in country to allow the numbers we see at funerals, at receptions. We notice there's a lot of socializing within the bars, within the communities. Those are the areas where we are seeing the high number of cases coming up.
With several variants of the virus circulating among the populations of the region, there is fear that these may get introduced into the island principally from international tourism markets. Only the British variant has been identified in St. Lucia.
In terms of a summary, the main variants that we note, the B117, which is the British variant, the B1351, which is the South African variant, and the P1, which is the Brazilian variant. These are the three main variants of concern. WHO has just recently added on the Indian variant, as you note what is happening in India. For us in St. Lucia, our implications, I will look to the AstraZeneca vaccine. It is very effective against the British variant, which is the variant which we have identified circulating in St. Lucia, and also for the Brazilian variant is still expected to work. In terms of the South African variant, it is not sure how effective it will be, and we are waiting on data to see how effective it is. So this is why the variants have now put a whole new twist on what was forecasted for COVID-19, and why for us as a country, we need to ensure that we maintain a lot of the public health measures that have been advised, because the impact on countries which are managing variants, as we see in Trinidad, as we see closer to home in Martinique, the impact that it has on those populations. We were managing one variant with our third wave in January, and we saw the difference in terms of the number of cases and also the number of COVID-related deaths.
Citizens have been encouraged to vaccinate in a bid to achieve at least 70% herd immunity. The chief medical officer says it's only when that goal is achieved that the country will be safe from severe forms of COVID-19. For the DBS News World, I am Zane Romulus.